Now what am I gonna do? Well, I guess I have a new job, you know? Here we go. Let's see. Let's get everything out of here. What all is in there? Huh. Well, yeah, I used to be blonde. Eh. I also used to wear contact lenses, too. Well,
that's gone.
Baby powder. Oh, wow. I didn't know I had that. I need that. We'll put that up there. Once everything's cleaned out, then we need to put in a towel or a tub, something to catch any excess water that might be in there. So we're going to use this towel. Okay. Shouldn't be a lot of water, and I'll move you up a little closer, but we're going to loosen this ring. It's really not a hard job. We don't even have to turn the water off because we're not going to mess with these two areas. That's our hot and cold water. We just need to get into this. It's called a trap. This is called the trap, sink trap, and it's curved like that so things settle in that curve, and it can trap things like debris and earrings, in my case. I really want to do this myself today because my husband has to do this a lot. I've done this more times than once, and you would think that I would have learned something and not continue to put on earrings over the sink. But we're going to loosen these, and this should screw. It should go, there we go, this way. And it should be hand tight. Some of you may have a metal plumbing, and for that case, you need a monkey wrench. I'll show you what that looks like toward the end. I have a small version, but maybe not big enough, but that loosens that. We're going to do the same thing with the back. There we go. Oh, there's the water. There we go. Still not quite loose enough. There we go. Ugh. And there's the earring. Here we go. There were actually two of them in there. Yay, success. Now I'm going to clean these. I'm not going to put these things right in my ears. It's kind of nasty down in there. So I'm going to go to another sink that doesn't have the drain off of. And I'm going to clean this out. Don't scratch the inside because that can cause more things to stick later. All right. I'm going to clean this up a little bit while I'm there. And then we're going to put our trap back on. Shouldn't be any trouble. Famous last words, right? So it's going to go up over there. And it's going to go up over the back. You're going to thread the little nut here back on the threads. Don't tighten it all the way down until you get both of them started. The back one is a little tricky because you just don't have as much room to work. I need to loosen this one. There we go. Put the back one on first, ladies. There we go. Finally got it started. I'm trying to work around the camera. That gave me a bad angle, but do your back one first. Make sure your threads are lined up. There it is. Not too bad. So I hope this goes as easily for you as it did for me. I mentioned a pipe wrench or a monkey wrench. If you had metal plumbing, you would need something. You wouldn't be able to do this by hand. But they also have a thing called channel locks. These may not open wide enough. It just depends on the size that you might have access to. Just try it and see. Or you may need a monkey wrench to get some torque in there and get that loose. That was pretty easy. If you had to do this for, say, a clog, which is common in our bathrooms, right? Hair gets nasty when it gets all clumpy and everything. But some things that you could do before you took the drain apart and before you use chemicals, you could try a mix of baking soda and salt. There's a recipe that you can do would be a half a cup of baking soda and a fourth of a cup of salt and pour that down the drain. And then you would put some heated, a whole cup of warm vinegar. And you know what happens when vinegar and baking soda get together? It's a wonderful mixture. My kids always loved watching the stuff bubble. But if you'll do that and put that down the drain, and even if you can kind of cover it a little bit so it can create some pressure, that might help bust up the clog. You can try the chemical Drano products. You can even try a commercial plunger like you'd use on your toilet. Or you could call a plumber. I'm sure there's one around that would be glad to take your money to come in and unscrew your drain and clean that out. They also make these really neat things that cover your drains. I will put them below in a link down below near my subscribe. Below my subscribe in the descriptions. If you want to see more of these videos, some self-helps to help you save money and not have to call a plumber, then click that subscribe button down there and help me out. Thanks.